Well, there's some breaking news coming in where the teachers of a government school in Telangana staged a unique protest. Now, by wearing helmets inside the classes while teaching against the bad conditions of the school infrastructure. Now, the ceiling of the school has been leaking ever since monsoons began, and patches have been peeling off the ceiling. Now, they are forced to teach outside the school in protest. So, visuals there of a unique protest by the teachers in the school. You can see the school teachers wearing helmets while attending classes, and on the other side you see the bad infrastructure of the school where the ceilings are leaking since the monsoon, since rains have been taking place, and that is the bad condition of the school. So wonder how really will the children be concentrating on their studies. But this is a unique way to actually wake up the administration and take note of what exactly the children and the teachers are going through every day and how much difficulty they must be facing when it comes to teaching the children. Let's get an update from Paul as well. Paul, really, this is a unique protest that has been taking place, but really, has the administration been woken up and have they taken notice?
Well, Amita, for students of Shankarapeta High School in Telangana's Sangareddy district, damp walls, ceiling that are leaking, and difficult conditions to study in is something they've just got used to, but they are saying they will not take it anymore. In fact, this unique protest by the teachers, they are wearing helmets to classrooms. You can see clearly in the visuals, even while teaching students in the staff room, the teachers choose to wear helmets as a mark of protest. For around 3 years now, these students and teachers have been suffering. In fact, the monsoons have just begun, and they were saying each time it rains, you can see the wall that is damp. They are concentrating more on the ceiling than on their studies, is what the student actually says while speaking to Times Now in one of the bites. In fact, the teacher says time and again they have brought this to the notice of the district officials. They say the MLA is the one who is responsible, who should bring this problem, a major crisis in Telangana. In fact, time and again we see KTR speaking about digital classrooms, about various things, various initiatives of the government on Twitter, on social media. Why is it that basic necessities like a government classroom cannot be provided to needy children, is the question that we are asking right now.
And what sort of action that has been taken by the administration? Because so far, looking at the protest, there must have been the teachers, as you were saying, they have been pointing out to the administration to take note of the situation. But what is the response from their end so far?
Well, Amita, there have been requests, there have been people, representatives from the school actually visiting authorities, district officials, local politicians, asking for this school to be renovated, or in fact a new construction to be built so that these students can study properly in Sangareddy, but no action so far on the ground level. That is when the teachers actually decided to protest by wearing helmets. In fact, presently the classrooms, they have shifted it outside, and below the shade of the tree is where the students are being educated in Sangareddy. A sad sight, sad condition for the children. They say around 600 students are present in the school. It's not a small number that can be ignored. If 600 students are forced to study below the shade of a tree and can't be given basic classroom, basic facilities, basic shelter to study in, I really doubt. People are questioning, what is the government doing? Can't they take care of basic rights of these children?
Absolutely. What happens to the basic rights of the children? Where will they concentrate, on the studies or rather on the ceiling, which continues to leak? But Paul, if you can give us a breakdown, how many really children that have been affected in this school? Is it only one school, or other schools have been affected as well?
Well, this unique protest was carried out at Shankarapeta High School, which is a government school in Sangareddy district. It's not like the condition of government schools are really better off in other places, but it's not as bad as this, we assume. At this school, the condition is really bad. In